Hello everybody, welcome to this tutorial. Today I will talk about how to do transient simulation in ANSYS Fluent and how you can model the air-water interfacial flow phenomena using the volume of fluid method using the ANSYS Fluent software, and how to create animation in Fluent as well as in CFD-Post file, and how to produce the video out of your simulation. And as you can see, the boundaries are very simple. One inlet and one outlet is there, and other are the wall boundary condition. And this video can be divided into four parts, like geometric creation, meshing, CFD Fluent setup, and CFD post processing. So if you're already familiar with certain part, you can directly jump into different section of this video, because I have divided this video into four parts. I am Dr. Kuldeep Baghel, and welcome to my channel. This channel can be really helpful if you are doing computational fluid dynamic simulation using ANSYS Fluent. We create several tutorials on this channel, and if this video helps you out after watching, please consider subscribing to my channel and don't forget to like and leave a comment. Now we can start the first part of this tutorial, which is the geometry generation in ANSYS Fluent. So start fluid flow Fluent and check the property and select 2D, because we will create the 2D geometry for this tutorial. Right click and choose the design modeler. You can utilize the other modeler, but I will prefer this part for this tutorial. And then you first can select the units for as per your convenience. Go to plane and drag it a little, and go to sketch, and I will utilize the line tool for geometry generation. So I will first create lines, and as you can see the V and H element there. So V is for vertical and H is for horizontal. So when you create the geometry, you can be sure that it is horizontal or vertical properly. And then we need to specify the dimensions here. So just select the dimension and choose any dimension, whatever you want. So I am choosing as per my convenience. So after generating dimension, you just generate, go to concept and surface from sketch. You have to first select the sketch, then apply, and then you have to generate it. So this is your 2D geometry created, and now you can give the name for this 2D geometry. Like I am giving a particular name like flow field, and then you can select it as a fluid, because this is a fluid domain, and then generate. Now you can close this part, and we can start the second part of this tutorial, that is the mesh generation. So wait a little until it starts. So first thing, I am going to create the name selection for different edges, and I am going to give it different name, like upper wall, inlet, outlet, and like the name of different boundaries. So you can give according to your conditions, or if you are following this tutorial, you can give the same boundary condition. And this is outlet, or pressure outlet also you can give. So these are our boundaries, and then again go to mass, and first I will select the method, and I am going to choose the this method, that is quadrilateral dominant, and then I need to select the element size, then sizing, and I will select this body part and give the element size, so you can choose any size. So I will start with some rough or coarse meshing, and if it is too coarse I will refine it. Generate mesh. It is too coarse, so I will just refine it. I am skipping those steps, and you can check the number of elements. I refined it using the similar element size by giving lower element size. Now go to next part, that is Fluent, and you can choose the number of processors. Just start. Here it can ask you for certain permissions. You just have to provide those permissions. Click OK, and then we have to choose transient time, and also the planar, and along with that we are choosing the gravity as negative y direction. Then we need to choose the model. We are going to utilize multiphase fluid model, which is volume of fluid method or volume of fluid model, and we need to choose implicit and implicit body force formulation. Click apply and close. After this step we have to choose the energy, but since we are not utilizing any heat transfer we are not selecting it, and then I am choosing the laminar flow for this particular case, and then we have to specify the materials. So air already there, you can change the property, but I will select water from Fluent database, and you can create or change it. Now you have both air and water, so go back to multiphase model and select the air as a primary phase and water as a secondary phase. Then go to phase interaction. So this is air water, so I will choose surface tension modeling or surface tension coefficient as constant, and also wall adhesion and continuum surface force. I have selected these tabs for this simulation, and then you can close this. And sail zone condition, this is very important. If you are using the previous version, you have to select the minimum density like air for here, but updated version this is default selected, and you can check the gravity and ambient pressure also, or operating pressure. Now this is the boundary condition. So for velocity inlet we have to specify the velocity magnitude, so I am choosing a certain velocity here. Now it's very important, you have to specify that this is going to be completely weighted by water, so the water is always going to present here, so the water fraction should be 1 in this boundary always. And then the default wall boundaries are kind of no slip boundary condition without any velocity, zero velocity, and also the contact angle is default, that is 90 degree. You can also change it to other contact angle based on your requirement or preferences. We don't need to change any other setting. So pressure outlet is also default, like it is going to ambient condition or atmospheric pressure condition at outlet. So now we have to go to method and we can check the method. So I'm not going to change anything in this method. You can play and change it. So the parameters I am choosing as default and go to initialization, because for animation I need to first initialize the solution. So let us first initialize before any animation setting. Initialize and then go to calculation activities, solution animation, and you have to fill these information like whatever you want to create about animation, like name, and here like time step or interval. You have to choose and then here like you have to go to new object and you have to choose the contour. Basically, suppose we are going to visualize the volume fraction as air water interfaces, we will choose the phase of water, and the boundary should be interior fluid or interior flow field, since this is interior boundary. So as you can see, initially air is everywhere, and then close this and click on this and OK. So we have one more important thing. We have to auto save for CFD post, because then only we can visualize in CFD post different time steps or the transient behavior. And then you can choose number of time steps and the time step size. That again depends on your flow physics of different kind of simulation, and I am choosing certain parameters as 10 number of iteration per time step, reporting interval, and so just click on calculate. Now during the simulation you can actually visualize results since the kind of settings you have given. So here you can see the liquid is coming with significantly high velocity, so the gravity effect cannot be seen. So let me reduce the velocity. So I am going through these steps very quickly because I am repeating the same procedure for all the stages, and then calculate again. So I believe we can see the effect of gravity for this case because the velocity is low and inertia effect is significantly high. So this, you can visualize this animation during after completing. Just click OK. And then we have to check the animation in Fluent itself, how it is generated or how it is created. So go to results, go to animation, playback. So you can see different end, start to end frame, and if you click run, you can visualize interfacial flow phenomena. This is really interesting. Just close it. So that's all for this Fluent part. Now I will go to CFD post part after saving this. So just close. and then refresh the CFD post part . You need to allow certain permission most of the time because Fluent tasks too many permissions. And then go to edit, again OK. So for creating animation or producing file, we need to first create the contour. So I am adjusting the domain for creating contour. Just click on contour. And now I have to specify the boundary. Oh yeah, which is this front symmetry boundary. And then I need to choose the water volume fraction. And I can choose the number of contours. So this is the contour. Let me adjust it again. So go to timer, here you can see the solution for all timer, and if you click on particular timer you can visualize the result for that timer. Go to animation tab and check this tab, like time step animation, and you can also specify range or time step or time. So let's click on save movie file to produce the output video. You have to choose the location where actually you want to produce your video. So I am choosing certain location. Save. So this is, I have to choose the quality of video, and frame rate I can also choose as much as I want. Yeah, so I think all the steps are complete. Now you can click on this and can visualize this animation. And in the next step, since we have saved it as a movie, so we will also check the produced video file, how it is actually. So go to that location where you have created the video file. Just open it and see if it is correct. Yeah, so overall we have created this video file using ANSYS Fluent. Thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, please subscribe, share with your friends and drop a comment below.